questions?
Know this. Ji banao bhai. You can't be as fast as I. You have to. Alright, so this shows a rough track. अब तू उससे पेपर ले रहा है मत तो इसको पेपर इसके पास है ही है तो पेपर पर है ना पेपर इट शोज अ रफ ट्रैक अ पोर्शन ऑफ विच इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ सिलेंडर ऑफ रेडियस आर कैपिटल आर विथ व्हाट मिनिमम लीनियर स्पीड शुड अ स्फीयर ऑफ रेडियस स्मॉल आर It's a sphere of radius small r, solid sphere. It should be set rolling on a horizontal part so that it completely goes around a circle on the cylindrical part. But you have to find out with what velocity you should project it so that it completes the full circle. Simple. It will roll without slipping throughout.
Sir, can we say that this radius is a lot smaller than that one?
Sir,
it is not small. You can't ignore smaller compared to. Where is the highest chance the sphere will leave the?
Sir,
to the highest point here. So if this sphere doesn't lose the contact at the topmost point, it will complete the full circle. That is the hint. Condition for this sphere to leave the surface is normal reaction becoming zero. Just do the force balance over there, put normal reaction zero, so you'll get something. And then apply conservation of energy between this point and that point. Simple. Same thing we are doing again and again. Conservation of energy, torque equation, there is just hardly three or four concepts. Once again, topmost point, draw the force diagram, equate normal reaction zero, you get a relation between velocity and gravity, topmost point. Then apply conservation of energy between this point and that point. Okay? Try attempting it. Do it your own way. You may be wrong, it's okay.
So is it 20 to capital R minus small r by 7 under root?
Which under root? 20.
20 by 7 G into capital
Wrong.
R minus.
You might have done silly error somewhere.
Oh, it's okay.
Under root of 25 G capital R minus 20 G R by 7.
No. Doesn't look that weird. Root 27 by 7 G R minus R.
So, but won't this just be the same thing as when you're using a string to push it in a full circle?
But here it has.
What is string? What is string?
Tension.
String and the circle. Is there a difference? Difference is there or not?
So over here it's going to rotate.
Force. String. The force string applies is a pull force. The force. The surface applies as a push, normal reaction. Why are you equating two scenarios? You are oversimplifying it. There was no law that one scenario is equal to the other scenario. Okay, so see the thing is that many times you don't have to learn, you need to unlearn. You need to throw away the assumptions from your head that okay fine, you have to keep on reminding yourself that these kind of assumptions should not come in your head. Otherwise mechanics will really be problem. It is keep it straightforward, simple. So the way it is. Just three or four equations, same thing you have to do again and again. That's all. Right? Treat every question on its merit. Don't compare one question from the question which you have solved earlier. Compare it with the concepts. So so easy to say like this.
Like the.
Got it?
Yes. I just forgot about that.
Alright, so normal reaction will be downwards. This is normal reaction. Mg will be downwards. And acceleration? Downward. How much will be the acceleration? Vcm square? No, by r minus small r. Center of mass's radius is r minus small r, right? It is moving in this radius, which is capital R minus small r. Okay? So, I'll write n plus mg net force is equal to mass times acceleration of center of mass. How many of you got this equation? This is not this, we haven't learned in this chapter. We have learned in not work by energy, Newton law of motion to write this equation. Net force equal to mass times acceleration.
So how do you get the R minus R?
So what happens is, if it is a point mass, then you have to check the radius. But if it is a rigid body, it is a big object, so whose radius will you take? Radius of the center of mass. Center of mass is traveling a radius of R minus R. So R is not radius of the center of mass, R is the radius of the path. You have to check the radius of the path of the center of mass, which is R minus R. Okay? This is equation, and normal reaction will be 0 if it just leaves the top surface. So when you put normal reaction 0, you get a limiting condition for it to leave the surface at topmost point. If normal reaction is little bit higher, it will complete the full circle. Okay? So condition for it to complete a full circle is such that velocity of center of mass over here should be equal to how much? Vcm should be equal to root over g times r minus r. This is the condition for it to complete the full circle. This velocity is velocity over here, not over here. Okay? Now I am going to use work energy theorem between this point and that point. Why I am using these two points? Because I have velocity at that point. Okay? Which is this. W is 0, U2 is what? Stop talking. Mg what? U2 is? Let's say this is 0. Mg into, this will be capital R plus R minus R.
No, so let's
see. Or let's take this line to be 0 potential energy. It will be easier then. So this will be Mg into?
2 into capital R minus 1.
2 into R minus R. This will be your U2 plus K2 is half ICM 2 by 5 MR square VCM square by R square. This is half ICM omega square plus half M into VCM square. This is K2, this plus that. Minus U1 is what? 0 plus K1.
It will be R, right? Small r.
What?
U1 will be mg small r.
No, I am taking this to be 0 potential energy passing through the center of the sphere. Half into 2 by 5 m r square initial velocity by r whole square plus half m into initial velocity of the center of mass square. From here you get initial velocity to center of mass. You understood your errors, your mistakes, whatever you have done? Any doubt or any trouble? No doubts. This chapter is difficult or fluids was?
Both are hard. I like this one more than fluids.
Both are equally hard.
No. This one's harder, but it's more fun.
Fluids. Oh, fluids was not doable. Okay, whatever we are doing is advanced level only today. Now when you look at the mains level question, you'll be like, oh, so easy. all this, see, I'm looking at the last questions of HC Verma. Even those kinds we have done already. So I'm not able to find a new type of question. All right, here is a question. It's a disc which can rotate about this axis. All right. In fact, it is rotating already, omega naught. All right. Now, gently, you have kept two masses, M1 and M2, at the edges. Okay. And M1 and M2, immediately when you keep it, you have attached Fevikwik on it, so that when you place it, it sticks there. Alright, you need to find the final angular velocity it will attain after you have placed M1 and M2 over the edges, their point masses.
Are they like diametrically opposite?
Not required.
So the mass
is M, radius is R, and it is a disk.
So the disk is vertical, right? Like gravity is acting on M1 and M2.
It's like this. Disk is horizontal. Like this. This can rotate horizontally.
Give me that worksheet. Who had that? Solve this question.
What I can use here?
Conservation of angular momentum.
Angular momentum. So, karo use. But isn't there an external torque because of the weights of M1 and M2?
Oh, so it's like this.
Torque is there or not?
So,
M1 normal reaction because of M2 and not normal reaction. The weight of M2 and M1. Torque because of M1g and M2g is about the axis that passes through the diameter of this disc, and this axis is perpendicular to it. So torque because of the weights of M1 and M2, that torque doesn't pass through this axis. Understood? So torque about this axis is zero, but net external torque is there, but not about this axis. About that axis, it is there. I can conserve about this axis. Fine. So initial angular momentum is what? I omega, which is m r square by 2 I into omega naught. This is initial angular momentum. This will be equal to final angular momentum, which is what?
M r square plus capital
plus m1 r square plus m2 r square into omega. So you get omega. Can I conserve mechanical energy?
No.
No, there is a friend.
No.
You can't.
There's more mass also.
What?
There's more mass
also. Understood. Alright, we take one final question. It's a paragraph type question now. From this only. So most of you got most of the questions wrong from this paper. Okay, do this. Stop talking. Stop talking and listen here. Finish this question, then we can all go home. A uniform rod of length L and mass M is pivoted freely at one end as shown in the figure. This angle is theta. Whatever is drawn, I am drawing exactly the way it is. Okay? Alright, the rod was initially vertical. उसको थोड़ा सा ऐसे यू नर्स्ड इट एंड इट स्टार्ट फॉलिंग डाउन रोटेटिंग अबाउट दिस फिक्स्ड एक्सिस. ऑलराइट, There are three questions on this scenario. You need to find angular acceleration when the rod makes angle theta like this. You need to find angular velocity when the rod makes angle theta. And you need to find the tangential acceleration of the free end of the rod. Now you should be able to solve it.
Initially the rod is like this.
Initially it is vertical, like that.
Verify when it's horizontal. Or at any theta.
At this theta, when angle is theta, find out alpha, omega, and tangential acceleration of the free end. Exact same thing we have done, similar thing on the second class of the rotational.
Which class is this?
Fourth. How many classes you missed?
Zero. And like rotational is zero.
So it is sad that you're not able to do this. Sad for you, not for me. You're not looking sad. You have one more week to practice rotational. Mark my words, you will not get time later on. Till your class 12th get over.
Can we have one more problem solving class?
Syllabus kab kharam karega?
So you get 2 weeks.
Oh, 1 month we have spent on this already. Achha, in between like the JEE advanced one?
Yes.
We can have it. I'll call you guys. Yeah. Find all three and then answer. Next, all chapters are pretty straightforward, like the thermodynamics was. This was a little tricky, understand. It takes a lot of practice actually. You can't sit here and think that I will understand everything. Okay, done?
Yeah.
Alpha, though, all of you might have got, na? Torque about the fixed axis is how much? This is mg. Perpendicular component of mg is how much?
Cos
or sine?
No, sine theta.
Mg sine theta is perpendicular component. So mg sine theta into L by 2 is a torque. So mg sine theta L by 2 is a torque. This is equal to I alpha, which is ml square by 3 times alpha. Torque into I alpha about the fixed axis. So alpha comes out to be 3g by 2 l sine theta. This is alpha. How do you get omega?
Multiply with no for omega
you can do omega d omega by d.
Other than that you can conserve energy also.
That's better.
Please find out using conservation of energy quick.
So it's root over 2g cos theta by l.
Conservation of energy, all of you please apply. क्या कर रहे तू? स्ट्रेंज आंसर आंसर आया कि नहीं कुछ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी लगा एनर्जी कंजर्वेशन आई वांट एनर्जी शुड बी कंजर्व
अंडर रूट ऑफ 3g टू 1 माइनस sin थीटा बाय 2
ऐसा कुछ आ रहा है 1 माइनस
sin थीटा सो इट्स कॉस थीटा
बट इट वुड बी सिंपलीफाइड
ओके आई विल डू इट नाउ फॉर ओमेगा First, write this. Work done, zero. I am using this as my zero potential energy. So final potential energy is what? The height of center of mass from here is what? This one is L by 2.
Cos theta.
Cos theta.
Cos theta. Yeah.
mg l by 2 cos theta plus k2 is half I omega square, right? So m l square by 3 I omega square, right? Minus u1 is mg l by 2, k1 is 0. Same thing we have been doing for entire class now. So omega will be how much?
PG 1 minus
cos theta.
Okay, you can integrate this also and get it. You write alpha as omega d omega by d theta. This is equal to 3g by 2l. Probably when you are integrating, you are forgetting that limit is from 0 to theta. So when you put cos 0, it is 1. Integrate sin theta, you get minus cos theta. So when you put 0 as theta, cos of 0 is 1. Alright. Tangential equation of free end is how much?
So it's just 3 that alpha into L.
Yeah.
3G
alpha
sin
into L?
3g
sin theta by
2.
Okay, now you are able to solve those kind of questions. Okay. We have a couple of more minutes. Let's leave it. Dekho, try attempting the homework questions. Those who have not done the homework probably was feeling totally out of sync today. Okay. And this is going to grow as you move slowly and slowly. Class 11 syllabus will be over, then class 12 will start coming up, piling up. So it becomes very difficult to catch up. Okay? So open your eyes. Open your eyes. Alright? And accept the reality that it is not straightforward the way it was in class 10th. Okay? Already damage is done. And probably it is permanent damage. You can't do anything about it. But if you keep ignoring it, that permanent damage is going to increase only, and you cannot do anything. Okay, when you are in mid of class 12th, if you are not doing the homework, it will destroy your chances completely. Alright, so just because you are not doing the problem doesn't mean that others are not doing it. Others are solving many difficult questions, and you have chosen to sit with them in an exam, JEE or whatever you're writing, okay? And they are better prepared than you if you don't practice. So they will naturally beat you down. It is natural, right? Now you can choose to close your eyes and feel that, oh, I don't want to do it, or I'm very happy playing video games and chatting, sitting, whatever time pass you're doing. That is completely foolish. Okay, because soon you will realize that after class 12, and I'm seeing it every year. Every year I'm seeing it for past 10 years. I'm seeing this. Every time I say this, there are people who take it seriously. There are people who ignore it. And then same people who ignore, they come back mid of the class 12th. And mark my words, they will come with all crying and everything. They'll say that they're depressed and whatever nonsense. But we can't help that point in time. Even we can't help. We can console you saying that, oh, it is okay and things like that. But then, if you don't wake up now, time is going to run away and destroy it completely, permanently. Fine? Waking up means that at least get where you deserve. I'm not saying get more than what you deserve. I'm not saying anyone that be or India rank 1 in JEE Mains or JEE Advanced. If you deserve to be in NIT Suratkal, don't take admission in local colleges in Bangalore. You understand what I'm trying to say? If you deserve something better, let it go and get it. Okay, it will be sad that if you deserve, let's say, a college like NIT Suratkal, and you land up in some third grade college in Bangalore or somewhere else, then you have to naturally prove yourself to the world that, listen, even though I have landed up in some not so good college, but I am good. For that, you need to prove to the world. Otherwise, world will not accept you. You have to work hard some point in time. Better to do it now. Otherwise, once you are in some third grade college, all of it is known to the world. Do you think the world doesn't know what kind of students go where? They know it. Okay, so make your life easy by working hard in next couple of months. And you have another 1 week's time to practice this chapter, which is naturally very difficult, I know, very difficult, because a lot of concepts are there. So it requires practice. Practice and get what you deserve. I'm not saying get something more. Understand the difference, right? I'm not saying get, let's say 360 out of 360. But if you can get 150, don't get 50. And if you can get 200, don't get 100. At least be around that. Okay? And if you are around 100, then might be. Okay? They don't be a score of 30 or 20. If you think you are at 100, maintain that. Later on, it can go up to 120, 130, whatever it is. Okay? So, don't make it worse. Just maintaining your status also requires a lot of effort. Otherwise, you may think that you are there only, but others are going ahead of you. So, not doing anything doesn't make your place stable. It makes you go down not doing anything. Because others are getting ahead of you, and it is all relative. Ranks you're going to get, right? You don't want to see your ranks in lakhs. But somebody will get it, na? 20 lakh kids will write the exam. 4/5 of them will get a rank less than 1 lakh. Sorry, more than 1 lakh. Right? So, probability of getting a rank more than 1 lakh is what? How much it is? How much it is? 19 out of 20, which is close to 1. Okay, so competition is high. Alright, that's it.